Welcome to Smart Business Show. Today we're going to talk about the difference, I guess the faulty thoughts around profit. It actually comes off an email I got from someone on my email list, which you can sign up for at curtismchale.ca/subscribe. And the basics of his idea was that he's looking for a niche and he wants to help people who have an existing site, but it's not performing. It's bad. Clearly they have some money to spend on a site because they decided to spend it at the beginning anyways. And that was the niche that he was going for, which sounds good. But then he made a faulty assumption. He said, because then I'll get high paying clients and I'll make more money. And so the faulty assumption there is that revenue equals profit, and revenue does not equal profit. There is quite possibly, especially in the niche that he's likely looking at, that if he goes too high, it's less profit. And that the most profit is in the, $1,000 site, where he has solid processes and he sticks to it and he follows his processes and he can do more, maybe. That might be it. So the assumption that you make that just because you charge more, you earn more, you will make more profit is a total lie. Last year I made most I've ever made by 20 grand, and it felt like the hardest year financially, and taxes showed that I had more money than I thought, and it's my fault for spending it or for not working well or for whatever. So I had less profit last year with more revenue. This year we're working to change that. I'm following profit first, and it is seeming to help a lot. It's feeling much better. The finances are feeling much better anyways. So don't get caught in the trap of thinking that because you have more revenue, it's going to equal more profit. It's not. It's easy to fall into that. If you can't be profitable in some of these lower price points for your service, so say in the, not in the $500 site, because that is quite low and you have to be very specific and intentional to be profitable at a $500 site. But say if you're looking at, say, $1,000 sites, you need to be intentional about it, and you can make a profit doing that. You can make a profit, absolutely make a profit doing that. But if you're not profitable at that $1,000 price point, it's not like you're suddenly going to become profitable because you start charging $5,000. It's going to be more work typically. And yeah, you need to have the processes in place earlier to make that happen. That goes for every business out there, right? If you're not profitable at some of these lower price points, then you're just probably not profitable. There is a base, right? If you're charging $10 an hour, it's going to be hard to be profitable. If you're already charging $75 an hour and you're not profitable, then that's, I would say, a lower rate, but it's totally a rate you can be profitable at if you're good at your job and if you have the processes. So don't think that simply raising your rates is going to increase profitability. It's certainly a key to it for many people, and I think most people I talk to charge way too low, but they can still be profitable at that point. If you're not, then don't fool yourself into thinking that simply increasing your rates will increase profitability. It usually won't. You have other problems to solve, like how you manage your finances, how your processes work, how your client intake works, all those other things, right? You need to work on those, maximize those aspects of it, get maximum profitability, and then starting to look at raising your rates really will increase profitability, because if you make more money, you have more profit because your processes are in place. Thanks for watching. Head over to iTunes and give me a 5-star review. I only like 5-star reviews. Keep your 1-star to yourself. Or if you're watching this on YouTube, give me a thumbs up. That would be great. Comment. Love to hear from you what you think about the faulty thinking around revenue and profitability. Do you think I'm wrong? Because if you do, you're actually wrong. But I'd love to have a discussion about it.